sorry, a little late as it is, we'll go on. We want to get rolling here as we do. I got a question for you up front. We'll pass the scripture to read the practice, and in a moment, kind of get us into a place where our hearts are ready to receive, and we'll jump in from there. So do me a favor, if you got your Bibles, open up to Psalm chapter 29. Psalm chapter 29, real quick. We often say this, when we come together, one of the things that we say oftentimes, hey, Kelvin, leave our headboys, move up, man. Move up. We got some seats right here. Move up. And a lot of latecomers to sit back there. Appreciate it, boys. And anyways, you know that, man, I want to see your group of fellas. Come hither. What's that? They don't want to get split out. They're not kids, sir. So, yes, sir. And, So here's what we say. Oftentimes when we come together and we gather, oftentimes you hear say things like, this is a gift, this isn't a burden. As this being a gift, we want to make sure that we have the ability to receive the gift. So putting ourselves into place and putting our hearts in the position to receive the gift is quintessential in this moment. So what I want to do real quick, I want to ask you a question up front. It's kind of one of those moments just to calibrate or just to recalibrate and get our hearts in the place and get what we're ready to see. The question I have for you up front in this moment is, right now, are you ready to receive? Are you ready to receive the truth of the scripture? Are you ready to receive a word from the Lord? The point of gathering, the point of church, the point of showing up, the point of a community of believers coming together and opening up the scripture together is to receive a word from the Lord. And specifically in the story that we're going through tonight, are you ready to receive a word from the Lord, or are you here for some other reason or purpose? I'm not saying that just because you're here for some other reason or purpose that God can't use that. Just you being here. But the point is, church doesn't just happen. We just don't show up and expect all of the things that make the church beautiful, all of the things that make gathering the gift, all of the things that make ourselves, putting ourselves in a position to receive, it doesn't just happen. And so I'm going to read a passage of scripture real quick, and then we're going to take a moment to pray. Psalm chapter 29, verse 1. Ascribe to the Lord, O mighty ones. And here's what I want you to do is we're reading this, the lens through which we're reading this. I want you to begin to think of the majesty of God. Remember I talked about oftentimes we fail to fully engage in worship because we fail to fully recognize who God is. That was the whole point of last month in our series, in our conversation from last month with God is, when we put God as majestic, as the lofty views and the lofty in the lofty place where God is due, all of a sudden we begin to experience worship on this level. And so, listen to the words that the psalmists use to describe God. Ascribe to the Lord, O mighty ones. Ascribe to the Lord God and strength. Ascribe to the Lord the glory due his name. Worship the Lord in the splendor of his holiness. The voice of the Lord is over the waters. The God of glory thunders. The Lord thunders over the mighty waters. The voice of the Lord is powerful. The voice of the Lord is majestic. The voice of the Lord breaks the cedars. The Lord breaks in pieces the cedars of Lebanon. The imagery there is that the cedars of Lebanon were these really dense, hardwood trees. The point is it breaks through when we say come thou fall, and we talk about how he breaks through the cedar. That's the imagery here. That it breaks through the harder places of our hearts. It breaks through the most dense areas. Verse 6, he makes Lebanon skip like a calf, Syria like a young wild ox. Verse 7, the voice of the Lord strikes with flashes of lightning. The voice of the Lord shakes the desert. The Lord shakes the desert of Kadesh. Verse 9, the voice of the Lord twists the oaks and strips the forests bare. And in his temple all cry, glory. The Lord sits enthroned over the flood. The Lord is enthroned as king forever. The Lord gives strength to his people. And the Lord blesses his people with peace. Ultimately, where this passage of scripture ultimately ends is we begin to experience peace on the back end of worship. When we recognize who God is and the majesty of who he is, the majestic place and the lofty ideas of who God is, when we begin to know him for that and we worship with him, we worship him with the glory due him and glory due his name, and we begin to hear his voice and we respond in worship, the the end result is peace. Again, this is the Hebrew word shalom. It means completeness. It means wholeness. We begin to experience completeness and wholeness through this process, through this movement, through this journey of worshiping Him for who He is. So tonight, as we jump into this moment, as we share the gift of gathering, I pray that we, as we move through this moment, as we move through this movement, on the back end, we'll experience the peace, the wholeness, and the completeness of the gospel, the wholeness and the completeness of our world, the wholeness and the completeness of this big, huge, mighty, majestic God whose voice is so clear to receive a word from Him tonight. So go ahead and close your eyes for me. Join me in a quick word of prayer as we jump into this moment. God, thank you for this moment. One of the first reasons we know that this is a gift is because we don't deserve to gather. We don't deserve to be here. We don't deserve in the entirety of who you are, in the majesty of who you are, to even have the ability to come before you tonight and worship you. The amount of sin, the amount of crap, the amount of shame, the amount of guilt that we've brought in here tonight, for the most part, will be a barrier and a hindrance. Sin creates distance, and so some of us here tonight, if not many of us, are already distant from you, and worship will immediately not make sense. So Father, in these next few moments, as we begin to repent, in these next few moments, as we begin to respond, as we begin to engage in responding to your love, to responding to your pursuit of our hearts, when we recognize the loftiness and the majesty of who you are, then we have the opportunity to worship you as individuals. And then we experience the gift as the individuals worship you, that we get to do it with our community, we get to do it with our peers, we get to do it with the person on the left and on the right, and we give you everything we have. So God, in this moment, that you take this worship as a love offering. We give this to you for you to be made fame, for you to be praised, for you to be glorified in Christ's name.
Would you guys stand with me as we lift the name of Jesus?
Even if I ran away. All things work together for my
Father, we praise you and we love you and we thank you. We ask that you would fill this place and that you would engage our hearts. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You guys go ahead and have some.